Did you know that there is a very simple way to define fallback values for CSS custom properties for CSS variables? It's really simple and really handy. On this demo, I have a primary variable set to color white defined on the root element, and this is applied to h1 headline and to paragraph text elements, as you can see right here, and this is working all fine. But what if for one reason or another you forget to define this variable? Maybe you're working on larger projects and file where this particular variable is defined is not included into your build system, so everything fails. In that case, something like this would happen. I will just comment out this property and you will see that our text turns black, which is not what we want. But luckily we can define a fallback value exactly at the place where we're using a custom property. So I will jump back to my text element, and here we have set color to primary variable. And if we want to add a fallback value, all we need to do is add a comma and a value that we want to use as a fallback. Let's say yellow. As you can see immediately, this is working. And if I re-enable my primary variable on the root element on HTML element, you see that all text turns immediately into white as this variable is now defined and the fallback value, which we set to yellow, is no longer applied. And the beautiful thing about this is that you can use multiple fallback values. So you might want to use a custom property initially, but you might have a different custom property as a fallback value, in which case you would define it like this. So the fallback would be var secondary, comma, yellow. This yellow will actually become a fallback for our fallback. So keep in mind that you cannot add multiple arguments here, but you can nest multiple var statements, in which case you can add multiple fallback values to your CSS variables. So now if neither primary nor secondary color is defined, the fallback will be yellow. If secondary is defined, well, this value will be used. And if primary, exactly what we want, is defined, set to white in this demo, it will work exactly as you would expect. So whenever you're dealing with CSS variables, particularly on larger projects, make sure to set the fallback values so you never end up in a situation where you have this inaccessible text like this one on your page. For more CSS tips like this one, hit that like button.